My name is Nirijan and his name is Dylan. And today we're going to show the analytical system that is found on the Volkswagen Golf Mark 6. This element simulates indicators and dashboard. So there is a dashboard over here. And as you guys can see, there is a light shape and indicators. And the system elements link together using the automotive network with the bus data signal transmitter using automotive data protocol. And now Dylan is going to talk about how the system works. So I'll leave.
The computer is connected to the system to monitor data flowing around the network. And the control computer can also define a message to the system. I will show you how to do it. Fold, now you can see from the computer we place a fold into the system, and the system also has boxes which is placed everywhere, and with these boxes we can have like measurement, electric measurement on each part of it. The system also includes at the back a box which allows electrical fault to be introduced in the system.
So now the system should have an error, and me and Dylan will be going to go through error and find that issue. So
let's start the topic.
So let's play with the lights.
The lights.
Headlights.
Headlights working. Working the lights and brake light indicators.
Oh,
there's a bug on the dashboard saying there's a fault somewhere in the lighting system. So it will be visual. So visually we can identify the error. So we're gonna play with the lights, just check from where it's coming. So we can see this the left right doesn't work. Real life.
So yeah, this indicates there is a bulb failure or there is an electrical fault. So the canvas is sending signal straight to the dashboard, so the driver can be alert and take it to the local garage or to the dealership.
And we can identify it with the multimeter. There's on the system there's a hole, so we can check the voltage of the current if it's coming. This one there's like 0.3, it's like nothing's coming. And on this one, the other side, the right one. This one you can see five volts there. And we found this thanks to the diagram, because on the diagram we saw like on this one is the left rear brake, and this wire is coming here in this hole, and the other side is here to 3.1.
So that's the
right side. So this wire, there's a current on this wire, but on this wire it's not coming. Sorry. On this.
It's electrical.
And from this unit, there's another wire coming, but it's the indicator. Yes.
I can't answer these questions.
So there's current here. So it's only this part, the bulb, is not working on this wire, on wire T3. This wire doesn't work. And yes. We now identify the error, and we show you like how to repair it. The fault,
and also this is the full wiring diagram. So as you guys can see, everything is working. So when Dylan tested each wiring, everything is working. As he said, only this wiring
is
broken.
So the real one. So for this one is here. So we check the voltage, nothing's coming, but on the other side,
You were like
5.5,
yes.
So we have identified the error,
yeah.
And this can be dangerous as well for the other drivers. Like they won't see when the car will be braking, and if the car is on the left side, he won't see behind him. You won't see the light. So we found the error. So now we have found like the force coming from here, from the rear left light, and as you can see there's no phone coming, and there's a visual warning on the dashboard.
So
last time we tried on the board, to the diagram. So the diagram we can see this hole is for this light, so we can check the current measurement on this one. So let me check it on the voltmeter. There's no current on this wire, there's no current. And I will show you the other side, so what it's supposed to be. Supposed to be 5 volt. 5 volt.
And that's this one.
Yeah.
That's 1 second.
Yeah. That's 5 volts on the multimeter. So it means that the wire there for this part for the
but you just gotta work out the geometry of where it
doesn't have any current on it. So we put back the current on the wire and we see what's going to happen. Straight to the box, we put the light. So now you can see the light's coming from the rear light. And you can check the current.
Make it so it's coming as a 5.5 volts.
5.5 volt. And let's check this side, it's the same. Yeah. So both are the same now. This one is working fine now. We still have the warning on the dashboard, and I'm trying to show you how to reset the system.
So yeah, the canvas will recognize straight away the tail light start to work. So it won't say any signal. So you will have the previous signal, as you guys can see. And to this to be reset, all you need to do is reset all full system and see if it's working. So that's how we're gonna do now. So we're gonna turn off everything. Start the car. And
put back the lights
on. Yeah.
Now you can see everything's working. You can check the brake light. Brake light's working. And there's no fault on the diagram. So the system is working again properly.
And so the dashboard, there is no warning lights or anything at all.
Yeah. So now the system is
fully working.
All right. Thanks.